You might have heard of a saying, a good first impression can work wonders. Well, your resume is often the first impression a potential employer has of you. So to make that first impression, it is imperative that your resume stands out from the rest of the crowd. Hi everyone, this is Shantini from Edureka, and in today's session, we will see how to build a web developer resume that will help you stand out from the cutthroat competition for job roles in web development. Now, before we begin the session, let's have a look at today's agenda. So at first, we will see who is a web developer actually. Next up, we will talk about the different salary ranges of a web developer. And then we will have a look at the job description of a web developer in different companies. Next up, we will talk about the different roles and responsibilities and also the skills required in order to become a web developer. And finally, I'll show you how to build a resume that will stand out in the crowd. And also, we will have a look at a sample resume that will help you build your own resume for a web developer's job. Now, before we get started, don't forget to subscribe to Edureka's YouTube channel to stay connected. Now, who is actually a web developer? So web development is basically the tasks associated with developing websites for hosting via intranet or internet. Now the web development process also involves web design, web content development, client-side or server-side scripting, and network security configuration. So a web developer is actually a programmer who specializes in the development of World Wide Web applications using a client-server model. Not just that, they are also responsible for designing, coding, and modifying websites from layout to function and according to a client's specifications. Now, this was the work of a web developer. What about the salary? Now, talking about the average salary of a web developer, in India, a web developer earns around 3,08,000 per annum. Whereas, talking about the average salary of a web developer in US, it ranges around $59,000 per annum. Now, the Glassdoor rates the average base pay for web developers at $93,000 per year. That's a much higher rate than PayScale and Salary.com, which claims a median of $60,000. So, these were some of the estimated numbers or the average salaries around the world. Now let's move on and talk about the job description of a web developer or what is their actual role. Now the first step in crafting a resume is by looking at the job description. So let's have a look at a sample job description based on the details provided by different companies in Glassdoor. So here is a sample job description that tells you what are the things that you must be aware of or what are the skills that you must have in order to become a web developer. Now, first of all, you need programming skills and in-depth knowledge of modern HTML or CSS. Also, you need to be familiar with at least one of the languages such as PHP, ASP.NET, JavaScript, or Ruby on Rails. Not just that, you must have a solid understanding of how web applications work, including the security, session management, and best development practices. Apart from that, you also need to have an adequate knowledge of relational database systems, object-oriented programming, and web application development. Along with that, you need some hands-on experience with network diagnostics, network analytics tools. Also, you need to have some basic knowledge of search engine optimization process, and some problem-solving skills definitely. Apart from all of these, you need a strong organizational skill to handle multiple tasks within the constraints of timelines and budgets. And finally, you must have the ability to work and thrive in a fast-paced environment, learn rapidly, and master diverse web technologies and techniques. Now, these are some of the common things that you must have if you are looking for a web developer job role. So these descriptions are collected based on the different sources from different companies who are looking for web developers. So before you send out your resume, make sure that you have all of these skills. Now let's move on and talk about some of the roles and responsibilities of a web developer. So a web developer must have experience in the planning and the delivery of web applications across multiple platforms. And talking about some of the common roles and responsibilities, you must be efficient in writing a code and creating websites using standard HTML, CSS, JavaScript, jQuery, and APIs practices. Not just that, you also need to work closely with web designers and programmers to produce the website. You also need to have a constant communication with other colleagues in the business to develop and deploy their content. Also, ensure that there is a clear establishment of what can be created within what time frame. Apart from that, you need to do a lot of research about software programs, maintaining software documentation, then implement the contingency plans in case of website breakdown. And also you need to maintain, expand, and enhance the website once it is complete. Finally, you must know how to manage a team and work together. So these are some of the common roles and responsibilities of a web developer. And these are the things that you must keep in mind while applying for a web developer's job role. Now, these were some of the descriptions or roles and responsibilities, but there are certain skill sets that are very important for your resume. And these are the skills that are a must for you to become a web developer. Now, there are technologies and knowledge that are common to all web developers. First, let's talk about some of the front-end skills. So for that, we have HTML, which is the foundation of all websites. Then we have CSS, which is used for styling the HTML elements. And then JavaScript, which allows you to interact with elements on the website and to manipulate them. Next up is the responsive design. Now, one major role of a front-end developer is to understand the responsive design principles and how to implement them on the coding side. It is an intrinsic part of CSS frameworks like the Bootstrap. The next skill that you must be well versed with is the building tools. Now, the modern web browsers come equipped with developer tools for testing and debugging. These tools allow you to test the web pages in the browser itself and finds out how the page is interpreting the code. Now, the browser developer tools usually consist of an inspector and a JavaScript console. Next, you have the version control or Git. Now, version control is the process of tracking and controlling changes to your source code so that you don't have to start from the beginning if anything goes wrong. And finally, you have the CSS and JavaScript frameworks, which are collections of CSS or JS files that perform different tasks by providing common functionality. So, some of the popular frameworks are the jQuery, Angular, React, and Vue. Now let's talk about some of the backend skills that you need to have to become a web developer. So first is Python. Now this is an open source object-oriented programming language, and it is definitely one of the favorite languages of most software and web developers. Then next up you have Java and PHP. Now Java is a high-level programming language, and it makes it compatible to run on any platform. And for PHP, it is a server-side scripting language that is used to develop the back-end logic of any application. And finally, you have the Node.js. Now, this is an open-source JavaScript framework which is used specifically for creating the back-end or the server side of an application. Through Node.js, JavaScript can now finally run on the server side of the web. So these were the different skills that you need to acquire in order to become a successful web developer. Now let's move on and see how to build a resume. So for building a resume, you can either have it in a chronological order or in a functional order. So for a chronological order, you need to mention your experience in the same manner that it took place. Whereas for a functional order, you need to mention your most relevant experience based on the job role. Not just that, you need to keep a few points in your mind. For example, your resume must be concise and clear in terms of formatting. You also need to keep your resume updated. Now, for experience less than 8 years, it should be a page. And functional resume for an experienced of 2+ years. Also, you need to prioritize these skills according to your job role. Don't forget to mention your activities that you were a part of. And finally, do write about the achievements and hobbies, but keep it simple. Now let's have a look at a sample resume. So here you can see a sample resume that will give you an idea about how you can build your resume for your web developer's job role. Now there are certain things that you should keep in check when drafting a resume. So the introduction should be very simple and should be up to point. Your education details should have details until your latest degree. And the next thing that you need to specify is your experience. So it can be a project work, internships, or prior job experience. Now, if you are a fresher, you can mention the projects that you have worked on and justify your role in it. But if you are experienced, mention your latest job role and the projects that you have worked on and your achievements in the previous organization. Also, don't forget to mention your technical skills to specify different technologies that you are good at, because that's definitely one of the most important factors. Last but not the least, mention your achievements and hobbies. Try not to stretch it much because it might distract the interviewer. So keep it simple. So with this, we have come to the end of today's session, and I hope you guys understood what are the different factors that you need to keep in mind while building your resume. So don't forget to let us know about your opinion in the comment section below. Till then, thank you and happy learning.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries, and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to Edureka channel to learn more. Happy learning!